and perils. Let us pray. Almighty Lord, you make us grow. Whether we want to or not, you make us grow to produce fruits for your kingdom. We ask that our hearts would be good soil, that our lives would be good growth, and that we would, at the end, produce fruit worthy of your harvest, so that we might be gathered into your barn. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. You spoke to them only in parables. You may know why. It says in this book, I had somebody point it out to me earlier this week, a page before this, there's this line that explains from Jesus why he always spoke in parables. Get this. So that those who understand might understand more fully, and those who do not understand would be even more confused. Thanks, boss. I don't know about you, but I don't always feel like the one that understands. Do you? Now, it makes sense. Jesus is saying some things, teaching some things that change reality. He, making no doubt about it, is changing social structures, laws, lives, the way things are done, when they're done, how they're done, everything. And just speaking the way he does, using the tense of verb that he does, will get him killed. So, go figure. He doesn't always come right out and say what he means. Instead, he answers our questions with questions that make us grow. These two parables especially really answer three questions. And I think they're the three big ones that people were asking then and people still ask today. Number one, why Christians? What's this Christian thing? Number two, what is the kingdom of God like? What is God like? And finally, number three, this is the big one. This is the one that we ask, at least ourselves, as a pastor, at least once a week. What am I supposed to do? And instead of coming out and going, all right, here's the flowchart, here's your answers, turn to page 23 in the back and you can fill in your numbers, Jesus gives us parables. And they aren't even about people. Christ talks about plants, seeds. Every time you turn around, he's talking about a fig tree or a mustard seed or a great sprout. Sowing on rocky soil and fertile soil and birds coming down and eating. Why? Well, that one I think I know. It's because, number one, people walk. People farm. People understand seeds and plants. They see them everywhere. But more importantly, those stories answer the questions in a way that give us more answers than a flowchart. See, Christ never just gives it to us. Unless we're talking about salvation. Christ makes us grow. So we get to the first question. Well, what is this Christian thing? Well, it's like those seeds. See, Christianity isn't a product. It's a process. It's not a point. It's a journey. Our faith lives are not something that we just pick up one day and declare, I'm ready, I'm here. Our faith lives start small. And then every day, as we rise, sleep. Whether we know it or not, our faith lives develop, and they branch different ways. And becoming a Christian is that growth. It's not the seed that was planted in us. That's important. That seed of the Holy Spirit, that seed of God's Word, we don't grow without it. But our faith is the growth that comes from us. And that leads us higher and closer to the kingdom of God. Well, what's the kingdom of God like? The kingdom is like the sickle. God watches and nourishes and plants and promotes and protects. But God watches for our fruits. Again, we don't know if we're making them or not. We're in this process. But when something comes of our lives that can be lifted up for the good of the kingdom, be it a pain we've endured, or a fruit that we've produced because of discipline or prayer or just dumb luck, that is when God comes in and grabs it and lifts it up as something miraculous so that others can see that through our weakness, through our meandering upwards, God is at work and produces wonderful things that feed more than just us. You see, we don't get that with a simple answer, do we? We have to develop that on our own. So finally, as we're developing, and this is the last one, what am I supposed to be like? You ever watch corn grow? This time of year, it's just starting. 4th of July, it's about... You should know that. And then when we get to the corn season, around August 16th, August 20th... It's so good. Sorry, just a minute. Okay. Now, picture with me for a moment. One of those beautiful giant ears of corn. Say we just went out to Mount Joy and picked one out at Ogden's farm. And teleport back 2 months to today and stick it on one of those shoots. What would happen? It would crush it. What are we supposed to be like? We are supposed to be like us. Not a plant, not a mere form, not a parable. We are supposed to be like us. Curious, growing, searching, questioning, trying on different things in our lives to see if this is what God called us to do. Not expecting to take everything onto ourselves at once because it will crush us. That's why the Spirit guides us. That's why God sent Jesus to speak to us in parables, so that we might understand a little bit more each time, so that in the end, when we are fully grown, we can produce even more for the kingdom. I sound corny. I work on that one. But it's the truth. It's better to puzzle it out and to live in a faith process than to have it handed to us. So let's puzzle together and see how we grow. Amen.